Detroit. He could hear the, I don't want you to kill me for no damn reason tone in my voice. So he said, sure, and then took my license. He went back to his car and ran it. I don't know how long it actually takes for police to run a license, but it seems to me like they like to milk them. Because of the videos we see of unarmed black men and women getting murdered on TV. On one hand, I'm thankful the rest of the world is finally getting visual proof of what African Americans have always maintained. Cops often shoot black people for no good reason. It's not paranoia. It's actually a very logical way to see things. I hate to make the analogy, but imagine if every time someone shot up a country music festival in Las Vegas or a movie theater in Colorado, we had real change. But in the meantime, they're creating real damage. That's pretty much the definition of PTSD. Reliving traumatic events like they just happened. Finding yourself trapped by your fears, day after day, year after year. Even if they're no immediately register, okay, those white people are racist. For better or for worse, in South Carolina, racism was pretty cut and dry. Racist white folks weren't going to any great lengths to conceal how they felt about us. To give you an example, one of the most popular barbecue restaurants in the city, CMRE's, be so successful, used to really get under my skin. Not only did I refuse to eat there myself, but I used to have fantasies of blowing the piggy park up with a bazooka. I would do it the exact same way one of St. Louis's boys used a rocket to blow up dollar bill spot in the Players Club. If you don't know what I'm talking about, shame on you for never experiencing the cinematic magic that is the Players Club. Over at a ski mask, even if he was in town filming a TV special, would put fear in the hearts of those white devils. Fear that they might very well act on. I appreciated his warning, even if he had to use that word to get his point all the way across. Sadly, Shane died a few months later from carbon monoxide poisoning when the SUV he was driving became partially submerged in some deep mud he and his friend and uncle were driving around in for sport. As much as we went mudding when we were together in West Virginia, I don't think he would have wanted to go out any other way. While I obviously don't want to get shot by a trigger-happy West Virginia cracker, those sorts of overtly racist white people have never bothered me too much. If I encounter some tiki torch-carrying white boys in big manicures, schools are good, but probably the area's biggest selling point was that there weren't any niggas living in it, except for me. That's not exactly true. There was plenty of niggatry in my new neighborhood. It was just coming from my white neighbors. I give you a sign up, and sorry, it's not time for some change in our government. Nope, you are saying loud and clear. Let's make sure America is for whites first and foremost, and when they look around their nice neighborhood, there's only one house ruining their vision for a pink person's paradise. Mine. So you're damn right my daughter is only playing in the back. As a result, even though I paid a lot of money for my 5,000 square foot home, I'm never completely comfortable there. I pay my taxes, mow my lawn, don't play music loud, and even my son. Things started moving in slow motion. He was still talking, but everything sounded muffled. Did this guy really just call me a boy, I asked myself? Did this white man in a suit just insult me and all my ancestors by calling me a boy? This club to talk about a video of him in a high-end clothing store in Vancouver that went viral. He had come to the store with a budget to shop for the wardrobe for a video he was about to shoot. Tori approached the salesperson about helping him, but decided the guy was giving him a race difference. PTSD in therapy. Even if all white people get woke, I still believe black people will be dealing with their own PTSD. When I think about that time running from the cops through the woods or getting pushed from PTSD, if you were locked up in a jail cell with a parent like I was, you probably suffer from PTSD. If you got put in the foster care system, you might suffer from PTSD. If you were sexually abused, since for many African Americans, the easiest way to think of it is anything that comes pre-made, there's especially in a bag associated with going to get help. Ron Armstead, the executive director of the Congressional Black Caucus, potato chips veterans brain trust, but a big potato was a whole food. Brothers keep cheese off it. A cookie or piece of cake for dessert is processed, but apples or blueberries are whole foods. Pasta is processed, but a salmon fillet is a whole food. They're not crappy diet. It was high in processed foods and creating too much inflammation in my body. But as I began to eat more veggies and less junk, an incredible thing started to happen. Not only did the splotches go away, but I started to feel much better too. Not to mention,
all animals' survival instincts are keen, and humans are no different. In fact,